The DPVR E4, a PC VR headset for gamers who hate USB compression. But is its DisplayPort really worth it? Let's find out. Inside the box, you'll find the E4 VR headset, ring-based VR controllers, AA batteries for those controllers, and a box containing a number of useful items. And underneath that box, a user manual printed in multiple languages. Inside the accessories box, the first thing you'll find is information about the E4's limited warranty, as well as both required and optional accessories. For instance, you get this USB and DisplayPort cable, which is required to plug in your E4 into your PC. And inside that box is yet another box, which contains a required power adapter, which has different plug attachments depending on your type of power outlet. Also included are optional accessories like these cable clips for pinching the cable to your clothing, earbuds, since the built-in speakers aren't exactly the greatest quality speakers, as well as these lens spacers to help avoid scratches should you happen to wear glasses. Since the DPVR E4 is not a standalone headset, that means it doesn't have an internal battery to weigh it down, resulting in a headset that weighs around 280 grams. The E4 uses an adjustable halo design with removable top strap that is also adjustable to three lengths. There are also built-in speakers, however, they're not very good. I personally don't mind using them, but I can also see why audio connoisseurs or audiophiles would not enjoy these at all. There are four built-in cameras for inside-out tracking that really don't perform great in low-light conditions, so when you do use this, make sure you have a light on. There's also a nifty flip-up feature of the headset, which I find surprisingly useful when trying to tinker with different settings without having to take off the headset entirely. The E4 uses a floppy, rubbery face gasket for blocking light. This can be removed, and DPVR have said that there is a fabric version coming soon that attaches magnetically. In the center is a proximity sensor, and the older Fresnel lenses used in this headset are not physically movable, meaning you need to use software to make any sort of IPDA adjustments. And finally, the microphone built into the headset seems to be pretty decent, but it could definitely use another pass to fix clipping issues when talking slightly louder than normal. The E4's VR controllers use a ring design and have a thumbstick and button layout very similar to the Meta Quest 2. However, they lack capacitive sensors, which means it's difficult to perform certain gestures in other games like VR chat. To connect to the PC, you'll need to take this block that comes out of the headset, plug in and tighten the mini DisplayPort side of the provided cable, connect the normal DisplayPort and USB side into your PC, and finally connect the power adapter to the PC side's block. All that's left to do is go to DPVR's website, go to Downloads, Support Tools, DPVR Assistant, click on Download, which will take you to the actual download page, and from here click Download DPVR Assistant 4. With the DPVR Assistant downloaded, run the installer, step through the different pages just like any other installation. Once that finishes, you can choose to log in a few different ways. However, this isn't necessary as you can get by just fine with visitor mode. Next, you'll step through a few more configuration pages, set up your play space inside the headset, then launch SteamVR and step into your virtual reality.
That's cute.
Whether you're performing tasks with fine precision like air-to-air refueling in VTOL VR,
refuel complete,
or wide swinging motions to show villagers your boomstick in Blade and Sorcery, the DPVR E4 will have you covered in most situations you'll find yourself in. Now, that isn't to say that there are no problems, because while it does fill in all the basic checkboxes of VR, it does so in so many slightly messy ways that they are difficult to ignore as a whole. For instance, the resolution and the triggers are so low, you can see each individual bump as you slowly pull the triggers.
I can literally count how much resolution is in this trigger.
The Fresnel-style lenses make God rays far more noticeable, even more so than I remember in my Rift CV1 and Rift S. Also, due to the Fresnel style lenses, the sweet spot is incredibly difficult to find. I spent a whole night trying to find the perfect placement of the E4 on my head and only found it because someone in the Discord recommended that I move the back pad half an inch up for the perfect placement. And a lot of that difficulty is likely attributed to a distinct lack of adjustability. In particular, there is no physical IPD adjustment available, and Fresnel lenses certainly don't help with that. And last but not least, the subpar built-in speakers and a cooling fan you can audibly hear as you move your head. All of these little things combined make the $550 price tag a very difficult pill to swallow. Now, if this headset came out back in 2019, it would have been a force to be reckoned with. Its main competition would have been the cheaper but lower resolution Oculus Rift S at $399. And heck, even a year later in 2020, the E4 would have been a cheaper, higher refresh rate alternative to the HP Reverb G2, which released at $599. But that said, it is now 2023. And technology has greatly improved in the VR headset market. And unfortunately, the DPVR E4 can't help but feel like it belongs in a museum compared to today's modern VR standards. Now, I realize that's a lot of negatives to throw at this headset. So how about we explore some positives? What does the E4 offer that most other headsets can't? Well, first off, the gimmick. The fold-up hinge on the E4 is actually kind of nice to have. It makes content creation in VR easier as I can easily flip up the headset to adjust things like OBS settings or moderate a live stream chat and then flip it back down and be fully immersed again. Another thing I thoroughly enjoy about this headset is the nearly perfect binocular overlap. This means as a content creator, I don't have to increase my render resolution or pixel density to account for any cropping to keep your viewing experience centered. Also, while I did say earlier that the built-in speakers were subpar, I'm not much of an audiophile. So I find that the built-in speakers are good enough for the gaming I do in VR, since in the end, I don't care as much about what I hear, but instead what you hear as my viewer. And one last thing, the DPVR E4 uses a DisplayPort connection, since it is a true PC VR headset. There is no onboard processor or battery to weigh it down, making it one of the lightest headsets I've ever had the pleasure to use. So, what does all this mean? Well, if you're a content creator, then I think the DPVR E4 will work well enough for you, as long as you don't care about your own personal VR experience. Its flip-up feature is great for on-the-fly tasks, and as long as you ignore the god rays and tiny sweet spot, you'll be able to stream higher resolution gameplay for your viewers for potentially less graphical power. Although this particular scenario is pretty niche. It's worth mentioning that my issues with comfort appears to be in the minority, as many other reviewers have not experienced the same struggle I have. Additionally, it is worth commending DPVR because they have been receptive to the concerns raised by earlier reviewers and have addressed most of those concerns with either firmware updates or even additional accessories on new units. And because of that, I'm sure DPVR will take the concerns I've raised here and do their best to address them if possible. So, all in all, the DPVR E4 is an okay option, as long as you really want that DisplayPort PC VR headset but hate cheaper modern alternatives.
Altitude.